Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in the previous session we have seen the parity check in the error detection, so which can only identify the single bit errors. So the main drawback of that one is it can't identify the multiple errors. So for that we are moving on to the second method in the error detection, that is cyclic redundancy check. See, for this we have to consider the data, and the second one is CRC generator. So with the help of this generator we will find the redundancy bits, and here we have to identify the redundancy bits, or we can call it as a CRC bits. Okay, CRC bits, right? So here we have to know about one thing, that is if the CRC generator is of n bits, the length of the CRC generator is n bits, so this CRC bits will be n minus 1. The CRC bits will be n minus 1, and initially we have to find the CRC bits. For that purpose we have to add this data plus this CRC bits, that means n minus 1 zeros, and we have to divide that with the CRC generator, right? So which gives the CRC bits. Okay, so hope you understood this one. So first we have to consider the data and the CRC generator. The CRC generator. So if the CRC generator length is of n bits, the CRC bits will be n minus 1. So if it is a 4, the CRC bits will be 3 bits. So the data, whatever the data we are considering, plus n minus 1 zeros. So initially we don't know this CRC. So this is for calculating the CRC bits, right? So what is the CRC bits? That means data plus n minus 1 zeros must be divided with CRC generator. So whatever the remainder we are getting, not the quotient, okay, the remainder is an important. The remainder will be the CRC. So the remainder is the CRC bits, okay, not the quotient. So data plus, if the CRC generator is of 4 bits, the CRC bits will be 3 bits. So here the data plus n minus 1 means 0, 0, 0, 3 bits and 3 zeros. That means the 3 zeros must be appended to the data, which is divided by this CRC generator. So whatever the remainder we are getting, that remainder will be the CRC bits. So this will be calculated at the sender side. This will be calculated at the sender side, and after getting the CRC, finally the data plus CRC will be combined and it will be transferred to the receiver. From the sender, this calculation will be done for identifying the CRC bits. So the data plus CRC will be sent to the receiver. So at the receiver side, so this is all will be done at sender. Okay. This is all will be done at sender. At the receiver side, so this will be considered data plus CRC. Again, the data plus CRC will be divided with this CRC generator, the same CRC generator, which will give zeros as a remainder. If we get the zeros as a remainder, that implies the data is not being corrupted during the transmission. So that means there is no change in the data bits from the sender to receiver. And if we not get a zero, that means if you get the non-zero value as a remainder, that implies there might be some modification or some data has been corrupted during the transmission. So if it identifies the data is corrupted, automatically the receiver will request the sender to retransmit the data. So in this process, the receiver will only detect the error, but receiver doesn't know where actually or what are the bits actually being corrupted. Right? So the only single solution for this error detection methods is retransmission of data. So only the receiver will identify whether the data has been corrupted or not. Right. So let us take an example so that your doubts will be clarified. Right. So see, and here the division means here we'll do the exam operations. Okay, here the division means, so that is also important. So here the division means XOR operation means, we know that if one is true and another one is false, we will get the true. Okay, if both are true or both are false, we will get the false result. So that will be done in the division process. Right. So let us consider an example. Let us take the data as a random data. Let us take it random data. So 101 and 101. Okay, 101 and 101. And the CRC generator is 1101. Okay, CRC generator is 1101. So that there are 4 bits. So the CRC bits must be 3. So the CRC bits must be 3. Okay. So division XOR. Let us take the data. So we have to find the CRC bits. CRC bits is equal to, so append this data plus 3 zeros, because the CRC bits are 3. So 1 0 1 1 0 1, and append 3 bits and divide it with the CRC generator, so 1101, and we have to apply the XOR as a division. Okay, so no need of having the quotient. Okay, don't follow the quotient, just we need the remainder. So we can directly apply this one. So here we have to apply the XOR operation, right? So XOR operation. So 1 1 is a 0, 0 1 is a 1, 1 0 1, 1 1 0. Right? So start from the leading one. So omit all the zeros on the left side, start with the leading one. So omit this part. So consider this one. So here there are 3 digits, 3 bits. Here we are having the 4 bits. So you can take this one 0. Okay. So again, follow the same procedure, 1101, apply here, it's a 0, 0, 0 and 1. So omit all the leftmost zeros, right? So omit all the leftmost zeros, consider from here. So 1, 0, 0. Okay, again, follow the same procedure, 1101, and here it is 0, 0, 0. 1. Again, omit all the left hand side zeros. So you can have it here 1. Okay. So after getting this 0, we are having only 2 bits here. We are having the 4 bits as a CRC generator. The divisor is having 4 bits, and here we are getting the remainder as 1 0. So in such case, stop the process and consider the 3 bits. Consider the 3 bits. So not the 3 bits. I mean consider the CRC, the number of CRC bits. So here it is 3. So we have to consider these 3 bits as a CRC bits. So here the CRC is 010. CRC bits are 010. So hope you understood, right? So first consider the data and append the number of CRC bits, zeros. Okay, so here the CRC bits is 0. So the number of CRC bits depends upon the number of bits of CRC generator. So here the same number of bits of CRC generator is 4. Here the CRC bits will be n minus 1, that is 4. I mean 3. So division operation here we are performing is XOR, right? So apply this divisor, that is CRC generator 1101, and we have to append 3 zeros for the data, and we have to done the process. While doing this division operation, omit all the leftmost zeros and start from the leading one. So I'm applying here. So stop the process if you get the remainder less than the divisor. Remainder less than the divisor. So I got remainder 1 0, and here 2 bits, and divisor is 4 bits. I have stopped the process. And consider the CRC bits, the length of CRC bits, that means 3 bits. So consider 3 bits. So 0, 1, 0 will be the result. That means CRC bits, redundancy bits are 0, 1, 0. So now the sender will send the data, the sender will send the data 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, and it will append these CRC bits to the here. Okay, so these are the data which is sent by the sender. So 101, 101, which is nothing but our data plus CRC. So data plus CRC. So this should be sent to the receiver side, right? So this will be sent to the receiver side. Again, here the receiver receives the data. See, receiver receives the data as 101, 101, and 010. This is the data received by the receiver from the sender. So this is the actual data, and these three are the CRC bits. These three are the CRC bits. Now again, consider the CRC generator, which is nothing but 1101, which we have calculated from the sender. So both the sender and receiver should use the only one CRC generator, the same CRC generator. Now again, calculate the division operation, apply the division operation. So 101 101 010, so it is divided with 1101. So here the result we should have, we should get it as 0. If we get 0, that implies the data has not been corrupted during the transmission, right? So let us check. So 1101, apply the XOR operation. So 0 1 1 0. So omit the left hand most zeros and consider from the leading one. So again 0 1 1 0 1, again 0 0 0 1, again omit all the left hand side. So consider this one, again 1 0 0, right? So 1 1, sorry, here it is 1. Okay, right, 1 1 0 1, which is again 0 0 0 0. So if you apply here, it is 0. So finally we got the result as a 0. Okay, if we got the result as 0, that implies the data has not been corrupted. The sender, the receiver will know that data is not being corrupted. So this is how we will calculate this CRC. We can identify, sorry, we can detect the error. So this is only for detection, not for the correction. So the receiver knows that there is no corrupted data, right? So if you change one bit, for example, if you consider this is the received data, okay, actual data we got is this one, 101101010, but here the second bit has been changed, 0, and here it is 1. Now check out the result, what will get. Actually the data is corrupted during the transmission, so we'll check it out. So let us take a 2-bit corruption. Okay, 2-bit corruption. Let us take the 2-bit corruption. Okay, so first bit 1 same, second bit 0 becomes 1, third bit 1 becomes 0, and all the remaining is same. So 2 bits have been corrupted, the second bit and third bit. Now we'll check. So 1 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0. Okay, so apply the same thing, 1 1 0 1. So all are zeros because we are applying the XOR operation. So consider, so omit everything. So consider the same, 0 1 0 1, and apply the same, 1 1 0 1, so that 1 0 0 0, and apply the same here. Sorry, here we can't omit anything, 1 0 0, again the same, apply here, 1 1 0 1, we'll get 0, 1 0 1, omit this one and bring this one here, so 4 bits again, 1 1 0 1, so we'll get 0 1 1 1, which is not a 0, it's not a 0. So this implies the receiver will know that some data has been corrupted during the transmission, but the receiver doesn't know that second bit and the third bit has been corrupted. The receiver only detects the error. So then immediately the receiver will request for the retransmission of data from the sender, right? So this is how we can detect the error by using this cyclic redundancy check. So we have to remember this thing. First data, consider the data. So next CRC generator of any number of bits, but depends upon the n number of bits, CRC bits must be n minus 1. And division is XOR. The first thing, we have to add the zeros, the CRC bits, the length of the CRC bits, zeros with the data, because initially we doesn't know the CRC. That means redundancy bits we don't know. So in order to calculate those redundancy bits, we will append the zeros to the data and it will be divided with the CRC generator, right? So then finally we'll get the n number of CRC bits here at the end, at the end. So that CRC bits will be appended to the original data and that will be sent to the receiver. And at the receiver again, that complete data plus CRC will be divided with the CRC generator, so that the result must be 0. We have to get the remainder 0. If the remainder is 0, that implies the data has not been corrupted during the transmission. If the data, if the remainder is a non-zero, that implies some of the data has been corrupted during the transmission. So the receiver can only detect the error but cannot identify the what actually bits has been corrupted. So the solution for this is, this error detection methods is only the retransmission. So whenever the receiver detects the error, whenever the receiver identifies that there is some data has been corrupted, so immediately the receiver will request to the sender for the retransmission of data. Right? So hope you understood the cyclic redundancy check. So let us stop here. So in the next session, we'll go with the error correction. So the receiver can able to identify the error and also can be able to correct the errors, which is not done in this error detection. Right? So that we'll discuss in the next session. So hope you understood this CRC, cyclic redundancy check. So if you are having any doubts in this error detection methods, so feel free to post your doubts in the comment section, so that definitely I will try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really understood my sessions, like my session, share my sessions with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. So thanks for watching. Thank you very much.